Good evening and welcome all of you. We are in our second session in the series Unleash Yourself, and I am super thrilled to have Amita with us, Charu and Sumiti, the co-organizers with us, and all of you awesome people. This series is about finding where we are blocking ourselves, finding what is hindering our professional, personal, mental growth, and unleashing our true potential. I'll leave the introduction part on Charu, and I will ask her to please proceed with the evening. Guide us, facilitate us. Thank you. You are on mute, Charu.
Thank you so much, Deepi. So welcome all of you. And so Unleash Yourself is an online series which lets you expand your potential, be it professional, be it personal, be it mental. And as Bernard Shaw has rightly said, you know, life is not about finding yourself, it's about creating yourself. So we want to be part of your journey in creating yourself the way you want to be. And this is the whole idea behind the series. And we meet every second Saturday and fourth Saturday of the month at 9 p.m. And in our journey, we have our awesome speakers with us who help us to achieve our goals and shed our inhibitions. So, and in today's session, we have Amita with us, who is a constant learner and believes in expanding herself in terms of potential in everything, in every which way. So now over to Amita, and thank you all of you for joining. And yes, before we start with our session, I'll be sharing a Google Sheet with all of you so that, you know, we can have your suggestions. And also, Amita will be sharing certain references with all of us so that whenever you want to come back and refer to those tools or references, you can use them whenever you want. So I'll request again to all of you to please fill that sheet. Thank you so much, and over to you, Amita.
Hey, thanks, Charu. Hi, everyone. A warm welcome. And my name is Nicodemus, as shared by Charu, and I have the pleasure and the honor to be facilitating and leading today's session. A bit about myself. I stay in Gurgaon with my parents. My father's an ex-army officer. My mom is a superwoman, a housewife, always been a housewife. Two grown-up kids, Arzu, who's a psychologist and a life coach, and my son Arman, who's into music production. We also have two little dogs, Oscar and Rio, the life of our house. And professionally, I work as a director of sales and business development with a French multinational in Gurgaon. I've had the opportunity to work with some of the best companies globally in my 20 plus years of career, and it's been a great learning throughout. I'm also a trained commercial pilot, and sports is a hobby that I really enjoy. Last couple of years running half marathons. The last memorable marathon was in Leh in September 2019. That was an amazing experience, and just the fact that I was able to do it was a big boost. Coaching is something that I do as a passion. It gives me an awesome opportunity to contribute, and in return, there's always some learning that I take back for myself and helps me continue to grow. So that's about myself, and I want to acknowledge each one of you for making a choice of being present here today. You could have been with your family, watching some movie, completing some household chore or office work, but you chose to be here today, and I thank you and acknowledge you for that. I would like to hear from some of you what your expectations from today's session is, what got you to be on today's session.
I want to expand, you know, to be a person who is capable of delivering her job to the fullest. We all stop ourselves with this belief that probably we know everything or we understand technicality of our job. And there is something called EQ, and which I mostly find missing. And so I you know, today as a participant, I want to learn what I don't know, discover my blind spots, and take one step ahead, grow one step more in my personal and professional life.
Yeah, thanks, Deepti. Thanks. And, you know, I know Deepti as somebody who is extremely successful, and I have seen her journey over the last few years, and I've seen how, you know, it's not that things always go your way. It's how you make that journey through those paths, no matter what, right? The will always change. It is never the same, and circumstances also similar. So thanks, Deepti. Yeah, we will be largely actually addressing the mindset that we, you know, we develop and we leash ourselves into, and how to break through that. Yeah. Anyone else?
Hey, Nagini here.
Hey, Nagini.
Actually, the title itself is so impressive. Like, you know, we work with so many people in and out every day, not only in office, professional, but also in the personal friend.
Yeah.
So I just wanted to understand what are the different ways to unleash, you know, either you or anybody else. As you said, I also am in the journey of a coach in the office. So I will be interacting with a lot of team members, and, you know, somewhere or the other, there is a small, slight line where you have both the personal and the professional way of dealing with people.
Yes.
So I just wanted to see that fine, thin line and understand more about it.
Sure. Thank you so much for sharing, and welcome.
Thank you.
So on cue, you know, I would like to share with you what this evening will be like, and talk a little bit more in depth about what today's session will be on. You know, this, today is all about you, and it's about me being able to give you a perspective on performance, which you may have had earlier or you may not have. Okay, so it'll be a opportunity in a different way to look at performance, to see what is it that I have started, you know, linking it with in my life. Where am I leashing my potential? Where do I put limits on myself? Why am I not able to achieve the goals that I set for myself? And also, session, we will go through a model that will, you know, help us not only for ourselves set our goals, but you can use that model to for your team members who are struggling or who are already successful to a certain level and want to be you know, high performers, and or also in your coaching sessions, should you be taking any series or like I am, or any coaching session one-on-one that you would be taking. So that's mostly what the session will be today. It is an interactive session, and I will need your participation. Because, you know, it's not about how much you will learn from here. It's about you being able to implement it. Knowledge is available. You can go to YouTube. You can do multiple other things. And probably we already know some of the things that I will bring out in present for you. The trick will be in you being able to implement it and put it into action. Okay? And we will address that as well. You know, some hacks and tips on how to make it happen. All right. So before I take this session any further, I want to, you know, give some acknowledgement, firstly to Agile Virgin Community of Practices for bringing us all together, Agile Alliance for India for supporting and nurturing India's Agile and Change Agents community, and very, very specifically Deepti, Charu, Sumiti for leading this initiative. So I'll just start my screen share. And there's not too much for you to kind of, you know, write or anything. So you can just listen, you can relax, participate, and share whatever, you know, whatever comes up in your mind. There is no judgment, there is no right and wrong. That's the space that I would love to, you know, have for us. So if you'll go to, you know, performance is what? Performance, like just said, you know, it's it's there in my personal space, it's there in my professional space as well. Often when we think of performance, we think of it from professional, because we hear of terms like performance management, performance reviews. We don't tend to associate it to our personal goals that we have set for ourselves. But we will be addressing performance under professional and personal scope, both. Okay. And performance in the dictionary is an action or process of performing a task or a function, you know, and full stop. It is understood to be what is the achievement that you've had against your set goal. Yes, there is a measure to it. And there is an outcome that you have achieved or not achieved. Okay. As an organization, as a team member, or in your personal goals. But the twist comes in when we start linking it, getting attached to those goals, okay, and the outcomes. And typically what happens is that we start creating stories and beliefs around the outcome and labeling ourselves and limiting ourselves going forward. For example, for me, in my 9th class, I failed my maths exam. And I started believing that maths is not for me. Mere se nahi hota maths. So I had an opportunity to take up science. There was a seat available blocked in my father's office in the AIIMS. Tomorrow he's from the army. We had AFMC. I did not take that opportunity because I said maths is not my cup of tea. Because once I failed in my 9th class, when I took up flying, there was a very difficult subject called navigation, okay? And it was a written exam. There's a written exam and there is flying. And people wouldn't clear it at least. They would take at least 5-6 attempts to clear it, okay? I cleared it in one go. Because this limiting thought that maths is for me never came up there. And navigation is all about maths. Okay. Had that thought come there, I probably would have taken 4-5 attempts, maybe 6-7, maybe 2. But that, you know, I was dwelling on it the other day when we were discussing about maths. And once again, I said, maths mujhse nahi hota yaar. You know, the minute the maths comes, mera mental block ho jata. Mujhe nahi malum. It's not for me. And ye kisne decide kiya? You know, I decided it basis one event and I made it so personal that I have not even tried to break that barrier after that. And I did not even get present to it. I had actually already broken that barrier, but I've not even acknowledged that. Only in my conversation the other day that it came up when my friend pointed, but how come then it didn't matter to you? So am I making some sense to you? Would you like to share some moments when things didn't go your way on the goal that you wanted to achieve, and what did you interpret from that?
I think I have a little thing to share here. I had similar experience. Only difference is I was so wrong. I always thought nothing is difficult. And maths is like, it's super easy because my parents always told me. And so I strongly believed in whatever they said. For me, that was magic statement. So I think around in class 7th, when I was struggling with, I don't remember what portion of mathematics that was, but that's when I realized, oh my, and so I would not put in any efforts because I knew, oh, it is easy. It's not difficult. It was only then I realized, dude, you have to put in some efforts and probably it's not that easy for you. But as you are saying, so the reverse worked for me because I knew it is not difficult. I could do it because fool didn't know it was impossible. So fool did it. That's how I feel.
Yeah. And I'll also like to call out, Deepti, see, there is what here in this aspect, it worked for you because you believed everything your parents said. And here they said something which was empowering.
Absolutely. Yes.
Now, there will be moments when your parents would have said something which is disempowering or you interpreted it as
absolutely
disempowering. And that's it, what would trip you in life.
Yeah. So that seventh grade experience gave me fear. For the first time, I realized, oh shit, it is not, it is not that maths is easy and I will have to make efforts. And I was like, shit, I'm so not used to making efforts. I just went on with this belief that, okay, it's easy. It will be doable.
Yeah, and I also want you to see that, you know, had you not done well in that exam of maths,
yeah,
what it would have been, because it was breaking a belief that your parents had in you. Now the baggage that you're carrying, because how would your parents look at you now?
Right.
Yeah. So that's what I'm bringing to your notice, that there is a dependency that we end up creating. Sometimes it would usually start with our parents, and then we make it our own beliefs, and then our bosses get involved in it, our colleagues get involved in it, our spouses, our better halves, and suddenly everything that they say is the input for us.
That's
okay.
True.
And my program is set on that. What about what you believe? Wo to kuch hai nahi. Everything is based on the input I'm taking from different people, and in the bargain, I start, depending on validation from others constantly. And there will be a point ki wo nahi aayega.
Deepti and Amita, it's Anvesh here. So yeah. I'm listening to your story. So might be I'm putting my wrong story, but again, I want to put myself here.
Please.
So like after clearing my 12th, I want to join Indian Army through NDA. And I tried myself, but I'm not able to clear the NDA exam. And my mother was not interested to join me as Indian Army. But again, I want to do, but again, I'm not able to clear my NDA exam. Then I cleared and I did my graduation. And after that, I appeared for CDS exam, Central Defense Services, and I'm able to clear. And I was the part of the Indian Military Academy, Dehradun. Mm-hmm. And I got my commission, and then I joined my service, and then I served for Indian Army for around 1.5 years, and somehow I got a severe accident and I got a permanent resection again. So after listening your story, I want to understand what is this for me? My parents are also not interested on it, but I'm able to get it. And but again, after joining that, what was my passion? And but again, I got a rejection. So, and now, but again, wherever I'm right now, I'm happy with that. But again, that is a different life.
So, thank you so much for sharing, but I've not understood what your question is. I'm sorry. So, are you asking what is the interpretation and meaning of your question?
Yeah, exactly. Because here, what I thought, I put my effort, I put my passion, and I put my all the things what I want to achieve. I achieved that, but somehow, my thing is somewhere luck is also there. Like if your luck is not supporting, again, that is also kind of thing. Yeah, people are putting efforts, sure. But again.
Sure. You said your name is Amrish, right?
Anvesh.
Anvesh. Anvesh, yeah. What this situation means and what I think of it is irrelevant. You know, what is the most critical is what you draw from it. Okay. Mm-hmm. How are you interpreting it? Are you interpreting it? So would you like to show you are interpreting the situation?
Yes.
If you could just elaborate a little and we'll see whether it is, how is it impacting you? So what is your interpretation of your current situation?
No. So again, the thing is my passion was different. I want that thing, but in starting when I cleared my 12th, I'm not able to clear those exams. But again, I never thought I will not. But again, after clearing my CDS exam and I joined that and I got my passion and everything is went fine. But again, something was there that is trying to stop me, that is coming again in front of me after some time, and I got permanent rejection.
Tell me, what is it that is coming in front and that is stopping? What do you think it is?
No, see, again, I joined Indian Army, I served Indian Army for 1.5 years, and then I got somehow one accident. So through that accident, I'm able to recover it. It took me around 1.5 years. Hmm. When I tried to again join back the Indian Army, they told me no, there is no, it's like my time is gone. So I don't have that capability to join back. So that's the thing,
I'll tell you. For me, I was 19. When I became a commercial pilot, okay, mm-hmm. I was the first woman pilot with Air India.
Okay.
I joined and there was a medical introduced, and what happened, was that I went through that specific test, that specific medical that was introduced for the first time.
Mm-hmm.
And I failed that medical. Mm-hmm. And my career, my dream, my ambition, my investment, money, time, everything gone. Okay. Yep.
So that is it like happened. Done at the starting or is it done at the end? How does it work?
So this was they introduced in Air India for the first time after I joined Air India.
I'd oh, you need to say after you graduated?
Yeah. Everything. Okay. What happened?
And so what do you have to do in this? Like, did you not perform well or like...
No, it is just a test. It's a medical test.
It's a medical test, Deepti.
Right? So like he said he had a medical test and that. And the test was an EEG. It's a gray area. Okay. It is done only if you're symptomatic. Then they do it for deduction of, you know, what is it that you're suffering with. It is not a test that you do on a regular person. It means nothing. Okay. And it has gray. Now, this is what happened. But... हम तो क्रिएटिव हैं तो हमने एक स्टोरी बनाई. स्टोरी क्या थी कि दीज पीपल हु आर इन अथॉरिटी विल डिसाइड कि मेरी लाइफ में क्या होगा और क्या नहीं होगा. एंड एयर इंडिया डिड नॉट वांट विमेन पायलट्स एंड सो दे जानबूझ के गॉट दिस टेस्ट इन बिकॉज दे न्यू दैट विमेन हैव अ टेंडेंसी टू फेल ऑन इट बिकॉज ऑन सर्टन during your periods or during certain times, your EEG will not be hashtag normal. Okay.
Oh.
And carrying all this with me forward from the 19 years of age, when I worked, okay, my bosses, anybody in authority, I had an issue because no matter how well I did, I always felt, iske haath mein hai sari power yaar, he will sabotage or she will sabotage my career at any time. And I live my life from 19 years till about 8-9 years back till I got present to it. Ki, dude, this is just a story I made, you know. I could have made some other story. Okay? A different one. So, main Meena Kumari bhi ban sakti hu. Main Madhubala bhi ban sakti hu. Main koi aur naughty actress ki bhi depiction. I'm choosing my story and I made it. And then I'm living in that victim mode forever. Now, when I'm living in that victim mode and I am living from the space and authority decide my life, that's how my actions will be as well. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
I have leashed myself. I'm not unleashed. I'm not free. At 19, I was. At 19 point something, when I failed the medical, I put that failure and I got attached to that failure. And I said, oh, mera failure, personal hai. और इन्होंने मुझ पे पर्सनल अटैक किया है. आई डोंट इवन नो, यू नो. सो व्हाट हैपेंस इज वी स्टार्ट कोलैप्सिंग थिंग्स इन बिटवीन व्हाट हैपेंड. व्हाट हैपेंड विल बी टिपिकली व्हाट कि कैमरा में क्या कैप्चर हुआ है, कहानी क्या है जो मैंने उसकी बनाई, उसकी मीनिंग की. वो आपने क्या कहानी बनाई वो आपको मालूम है. आप मुझे पूछोगे ना, मैं उसकी एक अलग कहानी बना सकती हूँ आपके लिए. बट योर कहानी is reality. It's so true for you. Yeah. And with that, what you have to be present is that that story, is it limiting you or has it made you limitless? If it has made you limitless, awesome. Keep going for it. If it is limiting you, you need to address it very quickly. Otherwise, what happens is it becomes stronger and stronger and you will keep validating it, collecting beliefs and making it stronger and stronger and it will take root.
जो
क्योंकि यू आर नॉट कम्प्लीट विद दैट सिचुएशन. आप अभी भी कहीं इनकम्प्लीट हो वहां पे उस सिचुएशन में. अभी भी आपको लगता है कि आई गॉट चीटेड समवेयर, यू नो. देयर इज अ, आई एम सेइंग दैट वर्ड चीटेड, मे बी फॉर यू इट्स समथिंग, right? You need to address it. And you know, that's what a coaching session will help you. It'll help you address that. Now you've got that, just hold on to that. Go back, see what maine kya story bana li iske bare mein.
Yeah, Amita.
Okay. Thank you so much Amita. For sharing.
Hey. Thanks.
Hey Yavish. Almost 30 minutes past. Last time I crossed the limit by 1 hour 30 minutes and I got a spanking by Charu on this and Deepti on this. So I will request you,
if it's okay and if it's not so urgent, can we move on and you can share what you want to in as we move forward? Is that okay?
Sure, not an issue.
Thank you so much. Please do share. We'll just move a little forward. I'm sure whatever you want to share will get relevant ahead as well. But we'll just keep continuing with, yeah? Thank you. And, you know, it's very important that you are able to be authentic and honest. Because if you will try and say, ki nahi, mujhe toh farak nahi padta life mein, I've got it all sorted. Maybe you have also. Okay, no judgment. Maybe you have. But if you're authentic and honest, is when you will be able to see. Like Deepti said, blind spots hain kya? Mujhe Deepti ke saare dikhte hain. Deepti ko mere dikhte hain. Hai na? And that's the beauty of blind spots. Hame apne nahi dikhte hain.
I ask, so I'm not sharing a story, just one quick thing. So every time when I find myself blocked, I reach out to Amita and I have this conversation with her, and then she always jokes, why do you think I know, you know, what you need to do? So I'm like, no, it's not that you know what I need to do. All I can say is in my story, you can see what are my blind spot, where all I'm creating those stories and inauthentic to myself. So that is what I reach out to a coach. And yeah, that's all.
Thanks, Deepti. Okay. So, you know, what we've established so far is that, you know, if we are able to look at performance from the perspective of there is a goal that I want to achieve, and these are the actions that I will take towards that goal, and then I will keep measuring them, whether I have achieved them or not achieved them. And you guys are from Agile, pivot on it as required. Okay. Circumstances are not in your control. Your actions are, your mindset is, okay? This is a GROW model, G-R-O-W. This is an acronym. I don't know if you guys are familiar or not with it. Sorry, jumped. Okay, this model was developed in 1980s by three people, Graham Alexander, Alan Fine, and Sir John Whitmore. Sir John Whitmore has made it most popular. And this is an acronym. Goal is, what do you want? Okay. Because otherwise, main perform kis liye kar rahi hu, mujhe pata hi nahi hai. That's why your companies will define a KRA for you. So you know what are you going towards. Then a reality on where are you now? Where are you currently? And so that you can then build on what are my options? What is it that I could do from there? And the final one, which is will or wrap up, which is, what will you do to achieve that? Okay. So this is something that you can use for yourself. You can use it while coaching others, and you can also use it for your team members to create their goals. Now, please, it's very important that you know you would know that as a coach, you are not to give the answers. And why would it be critical that you don't give the answers and the solution?
We all can come from our biases, or we can see it for others, but if we tell them, we are probably clouding them again with what we can see.
That plus, I could have a dream, Deepti, for you, but it's not your dream.
Absolutely.
Right. And maybe, you know, I am your partner and you're in love with me and things are awesome. And that time you're driving towards that dream, and then something happens in that. It's a very externally dependent dream. Right. But when it's your dream, when it's your passion, it's your goal, you have put it down, you know, you start owning it.
And okay. I think if we can let those people enable what they want to do in their term itself, then they will take those as accountability and commitment.
Absolutely.
We are
so well said. Yes, yes. And like you said, biases hain, wo sab point bhi ekdam valid hain. Meri khud limitations hain. You know, I am also a human being coming with certain baggages and limitations. Ye nahi hai ki Amita ek coach hai ya, you know, XYZ koi coach hai, so they've got it. They've got the code. You keep working on it. And like you said, the ownership is there, right? Okay. So moving forward, this is a kind of a template that you can use. Very simple. On Excel, just put goal setting, current reality, options, and the way forward. Okay. And then the person starts filling up on the notes. So Abhi, first thing is that you know, if it is you who's writing that goal, you could do that right now as well. You know, pick up a goal, any goal that you want to achieve. Okay. What are the questions that you would ask yourself or the team member? You know, what is a goal that you need to have some kind of a clarity about that goal? It needs to be what they define as a SMART goal, which is specific, measurable, attainable, realistic, and time bound. Okay. Now, I am in a service industry, and if I say ki I want my customer to be happy, wo measurable nahi hai, wo specific nahi hai. You know, it's a very generic statement. What I understand by customer happy and what customer understands, what my boss understands, everything could have a different, meaning and a measure. So you need to be specific. I want to get my customer satisfaction up by 15%. Now that's a specific goal. It is also measurable. Is it attainable? Now I say I want to up it by 90%. Is it attainable? You know, I want to, beat my timing of my run by like 1 hour, you know. So now it's by a certain date. So it's specific and measurable, but is it attainable? Or am I getting too, unrealistic about it? So those are some of the things which are very important that you look into. If you're working on something that is relatively new for you, okay, and you've probably, in inverted commas, failed at it, not been able to achieve it, or whatever story or conversation you have about it, make that goal smaller in size. Okay, just the way when you're lighting fire, you need smaller twigs to catch fire first, and that will enable it, give you the momentum that you need to go further with velocity. So make smaller goals. Get into a position of strength, get momentum, and start moving forward, making larger and larger goals. There is a book that I recommend, Atomic Habits by James Clear, which he talks about his own life, about how he made changes in his habits and small changes that eventually got compounded. You know, if anyone of you is in finance or investment, you'll understand the power of compounding there. I will be sharing with you what are the other questions that you can ask while this goal setting is on. Any questions so far?
So Amita, I have one question on attainability.
Hmm.
When you said, a goal, whatever we are setting, if we think that it is attainable. So how to set that limit? Because it's again about limiting yourself. Like, I want to achieve something huge, but then, right now I don't feel that is attainable. I mean, how to reach to an attainable goal? I got that point that
Yeah. We
need to split it in for smaller chunks so that we achieve, we reach there. But how do you set your limit to be attainable?
Awesome, Charu. Thank you. What you're talking about is a vision. Okay. I want to have something which is, मुझे खुद नहीं पता मैं वहां तक पहुंचूंगी भी कैसे, right? Goals क्या हैं? Goals realistic कैसे पता चलेगा? जैसे somebody wants to lose weight, okay? For example, अगर मैं पहले ही बोल दूं मुझे तो ना 100 kg weight loss करना है या 50 kg weight loss करना है, it just sounds, I will start gung ho on it, but वो somewhere down the journey chances are कि वो छूट जाएगा मेरे हाथ से, क्योंकि मैंने ना थोड़ा अनरियलिस्टिक गोल बना दिया टू बिगिन विद, और मेरी वो स्ट्रेंथ नहीं है. इट्स नॉट दैट आई एम ऑलरेडी अ पर्सन हूज यू नो हु जस्ट नीड्स टू लूज 2-5 kgs. इट्स नॉट लाइक दैट. देयर इज अ ह्यूज अमाउंट. दैट मींस आई एम, दैट्स नॉट माय एरिया ऑफ स्ट्रेंथ करंटली. देयर इज समथिंग वेयर आई एम कॉन्स्टेंटली ट्रिपिंग एंड फॉलिंग ऑन, व्हिच हैज मेड माय वेट रीच वेयर इट हैज रीच्ड. इफ इट इज नॉट अ मेडिकल कंडीशन, इफ इट इज नॉट ड्यू टू अ मेडिकल कंडीशन, आई हैव लेट गो माय सेल्फ.
So that goal, if I make it more realistic, I will lose 5 kgs every month. Okay, then it becomes attainable. It is not that you're limiting yourself, you are just making it more realistic. Because मैं अगर बहुत ही कुछ, जैसे कि मैं सेल्स टीम में हूँ, मुझे अगर कोई अनरियलिस्टिक सा टारगेट मेरे बॉस दे देगा, क्या टेंडेंसी होगी? ह्यूमन टेंडेंसी होती है, until unless I've practiced and practiced and evolved there, that मैं बोलूंगी बॉस ये मुझसे नहीं होने वाला यार, what is this nonsense? You know, ये क्या बात हुई?
But madam, don't you think it is same like vision may be same चीज है? So how will you actually differentiate between goals and vision?
गोल्स इज लाइक आप विजन है कि मेरे को चांद तक जाना है, वो मेरा विजन है. मेरे गोल क्या आएंगे उससे पहले? छोटे छोटे स्टेप्स आएंगे ना. हाउ विल आई, मेरे को छत तक जाना है, मेरे को छत जा सकती हूँ. अब मैं छत जाना है इज अ मोर यू नो रियलिस्टिक गोल. मुझे चांद जाना है इज मोर ऑफ अ विजन. मैं कहीं गई नहीं हूँ, मैं घर से छत तक नहीं गई हूँ, मुझे सीधे चांद चले जाना है.
So goals are measurable items, whereas vision is imaginary dream where what I can.
You vision, you may not know how to get there. It looks larger than life, but yes, you're passionate about it, and maybe somewhere it might, you know, like I want to contribute to mankind is a vision. But mera goal wo nahi hai, kyunki main usko kaise measure karu? Mere ko usko karna padega. Okay, I want to be a coach. I want to have. I want to reach out and connect with 10 people, right? And I will do that in this much of time period. Am I able to give you the vision?
Okay, not completely convinced, but okay.
Give me something that you are working on. Give me a goal of yours. Let's work on that.
No, in terms of goal, there are so many different goals in so many different line of business. But एक, vision is something.
हाँ. Vision.
जैसे मैं एक simple example दे सकता हूँ कि I'm trying to create one leadership team here within my team, so that I don't have to get into daily transactional mode and all.
ये तो ये
right.
ये so अभी ये जो आपने बोला है ना, it's a generic statement, right? It's like a let's say yeah. It's like a version of a vision. Goal का क्या होगा ना? Specific होगा. Like if you'll see the screen right now, specific banaoge. Smart goals will be smart. Kya hai? S is for specific. Kaun hoga? Kaise hoga? Kab hoga? Where?
Exactly.
Then you will be able to measure it because you've put some measures to it. I do not know ki main nikli hu Jaipur ke liye aur main ja rahi hu alag direction mein. Mujhe pata kaise chalega? When do I pivot? When do I change my strategy?
That's what I'm trying to say, madam. I think goals is relative to measurement, measurable items. I think you have listed down. These are different categories. That's nice. So vision is something, a normal statement, general statement, which I am passionate to achieve. Is that statement correct?
Broadly, yes. And multiple goals you might need to, and your goals will keep changing, right? As your journey exactly. goes. Initially, yeah. my goal might be कि मेरे को half marathon करना है. मेरा vision क्या है? मेरा vision है कि मेरे को Ironman करना है complete. ठीक है? That's a vision that I have. I will now make goals towards it, and they will have milestones on it, and I will keep measuring my progress.
Yeah, Amita, just to add on what you just said, I think you're very true in what you just said. I think vision is something which you set as a roadmap towards the future. It could be any generic statement or a vision or mission, and then these visions are actually driven. This vision is achieved through strategies, and then strategies when boiled down, you can map to specific tasks which you want to achieve, and those can be targeted through goals. I mean, something of that sort.
Yeah.
That's how I envision.
Yeah. So goals will be like your milestones on your journey. Like, main kya kar rahi hu? Meko ek, let's say I have to plan a holiday. First, to make, until it's an impromptu thing and tum, whatever you're doing, it's random. Tum bas uthe, char dost nikal liye. Okay, that's different. But let's say I'm planning a vacation. Sabse pehle to main sochungi na, ki mujhe kahan jana hai. If I don't even know mujhe kahan jana hai, kya karna hai, how will I start making the plan?
True.
Right? So that's why goals become very important. And it has to be inspiring. It has to be challenging. Otherwise, and that is, you know, it's a tip. These are just tips of how to frame your goals. Being smart at it is ki main usko specific rakh rahi hu, main measurable rakh rahi hu, attainable rakh rahi hu, relevant. Attainable does not mean limit kar rahi hu. Change your goal, achieve it, and upgrade that goal. Next level, next level, next level. It's just your stairs up. First floor pahuncho, up second floor, up third floor, like that.
Hi, Amrita. Vikramjeet this side. Sorry, I have a question here. How are you?
I'm doing well. Thank you.
Thank you. So quick question here, right? If you know, like you have a baby steps, like 5 or 6 in order to achieve your goals, and you know, on the fourth step or third step, there is a unknown risk, right? So being a project manager, you should, or being in the side of a goal achievement, you actually start working on that risk upfront in order to mitigate it, or you should achieve first and second and then just wait for third to come.
Okay, so Vikram, you know, your risk will be again, so life is going to be an uncertainty. Some risks That's you right. will know uphand, like you're saying, as a project manager, I can anticipate, okay, yep. from my experience and from others' experience.
Yep.
And plan for it, right? And what we were talking about in the GROW model, you know, the first one is just the goal setting.
Right.
And then you start... then you move on to the current reality and the options. When you come on the options and the way forward is when you will address those risks and challenges that you can anticipate.
Okay.
They will fall into your planning under GROW. That's why it's a structure, you know, on which you can put in.
Mm-hmm.
So, for example, in my current reality, I will start putting in where I am right now. Okay, very often, like let's say, main phir se weight loss ka le leti hu, you're going to a gym. Okay, main at least 3-4 saal se na, like a donation every year in January, typically wo resolution banake, I pay the annual fee and then I don't end up going. 3 mahine chale jate hain, then the whole thing just goes. Okay, so this is an yearly donation I do, and morning I'll think, okay, I'll get up and I will go run, and this is something that I enjoy. Okay, this is something I enjoy, and now I've decided ki mere bas ki baat nahi hai. Every morning, okay, mere se 3 saal se main ye kar rahi hu. This is exactly when I need to get present to the current reality and tell myself that this is what I'm doing about it now, and this is the impact. But also reality is कि मैंने उसके बारे में कहानी बना ली है कि मेरे से नहीं होगा. क्यों नहीं होगा भाई? मंडे के बाद जब वेंसडे आया, वो वेंसडे एक नया दिन है. How come Monday now decides what my Wednesday will be?
ये तो आपका माइंड
doesn't decide. मेरा माइंडसेट है. Wednesday is a new opportunity for me, and that applies to anything that you want to do.
Yep.
Right? Any goal that you might have, anything that you've not achieved so far. That is why small habits, small goals are important, because then when you build that momentum, mm-hmm. you are able to, you know, that confidence is built. The conversation changes. Main ye kar sakta hoon. Main ye kar sakti hoon. Main ye karke dikhaunga. Right? Otherwise, vis-a-vis, main waise hi nahi uth sakti hoon. Ab subah mere mummy aake mujhe bolte hai, tu har roj alarm lagati hai, tu uthti to hai nahi, to bas gaya. Over.
Right. Preconceived notion hai, basically, or jo aapke mindset pe aa jata hai, and then you give up, right?
Absolutely. And today, you know, we are discussing. So there will be certain, I feel there are broadly 3 pillars towards performance, okay? One is your mindset, extremely critical, and that is what we are discussing today. And there will be when you examine reality, when you're putting up a goal, it's very important to be present to your mindset. Or if you're coaching somebody, constantly asking them the right kind of questions so that they are able to move away from the very surface level things they say to you or themselves. You need to dig a little deeper. Okay?
All right. Because in between, the priorities keeps on changing and it will really affect your end milestones, right? Suppose if
I
tell you something, and in between something comes in, right? Like for example, COVID comes in, right? I have some realistic milestone which I set it up for myself, but COVID screwed up right in between, and this would be push my end deliverable achieve date, right?
That again speaks to your flexible and growth mindset, right? Now, अब तुम उसके लेके एक कहानी बना के अटक गए कि मेरा जीवन तो कोविड ने बर्बाद कर दिया, कि तुमने और रास्ते ढूंढे उस मौके पे. That will depend कि तुमने वो मसल है जो flexible mindset का कितना grow किया है.
Right.
Are you able to pivot? बोलना बड़ा अच्छा लगता है, pivot, pivot. कर सकते हो क्या? Because life is uncertain. We like to think it is. What has COVID done? COVID has just magnified.
I just wanted to bring us all on timer.
Okay. Sorry, it would be endless. No worries, Amita. I can call you some other thing and you can continue, please. Sorry to.
We respond. Will have another session after 2 weeks. And I'm available on call also anytime.
You are doing beautifully articulated this thing. This is super. Thank you. Yeah. I'm being Thank part you. Of it. I'm privileged.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Thanks, Deepti, for calling that out. Okay, so this is what the current reality is. What is happening right now? What, who, when, how often? मैंने सब कुछ कर लिया वेट लॉस के लिए. अच्छा, क्या क्या किया? दो बार मैंने वो डाइट ट्राई करी, फिर वो क्या, तो सब कुछ नहीं कर लिया. मतलब डोंट गिव यूनिवर्सल स्टेटमेंट, यू नो, पुट इट डाउन, पुट इट डाउन, पुट इट डाउन. दैट विल हेल्प यू गेट टू द रूट ऑफ थिंग्स. डज दिस गोल कॉन्फ्लिक्ट विद सम अदर गोल और ऑब्जेक्टिव्स दैट आई हैव? व्हाट स्टेप्स हैव यू ऑलरेडी टेकन? How is this impacting you currently? Is it impacting your health? Is it impacting your relationships? It'll also give you which the third pillar is, which, you know, I said there is mindset, there is what structures you are able to put, and third being context, extremely important. The motivation, you do actually doing something. This is about exploring the options that you have.
Yeah, so I think, Amita ma'am, the last slide, that was a very important point which you have put there, that is there any something which is stopping you to achieve the current one, what you are doing, and is that conflict? Yes. So I know you may ask me again back that you have to define your priority now, but today everything is on priority, high priority. How am I supposed to manage? I know answer, I have to find it myself, but still, can you give me your thought? Can you give me some thought here? How you manage all these conflicts of these goals and everything is on high
priority? I agree. My list always have, I mean, as much as we talk about Agile, I in fact prioritize, you know, to add on to your question, even prioritize, then my, you know, backlog has at least 20 items. And then
so
it's...
Uske na, there could be a couple of reasons. One, is your to-do list unrealistic? Or... are there structures missing or context missing? For me, for example, I am responsible for doing jhadu pocha and bartan at home. Okay. It's not a task that I'm looking forward to early in the morning, believe me. But I've realized that that is my, I feel I've cracked the code there when it comes to this or doing any exercise, which my mind tells me the otherwise, you know, chhod yaar, mat jana, so jana. Same way for this. If I don't give any thought to it, just get up, do the action, I complete my task. Main agar wo analysis paralysis mein chali jaun na, if I give my mind time to give me reason for not doing something, wo mere ko aise dega na, speed se. And I'll get caught in that. What Deepti is saying. Now what you are saying about priority, sorry, what is it you wanted to say?
No, I'm in aligned with Deepti also. So that's the same thing here also. And hum log utna time bhi nahi milta hai ki analyze kar paye. Yes, at the end of the day or starting of the day, hum koshish karte hain analyze karne ka. But as our day progress, so many new things comes, right?
So they are saying... Come. You can only plan, right? You cannot say ki mera din aisa hi jayega. Maine bol diya.
बिल्कुल नहीं, बिल्कुल नहीं.
आपने तो जिस दिन वो बोला, देखो उस दिन तो कतई नहीं जाएगा.
बिल्कुल नहीं,
है ना? So because man proposes and God disposes, and कभी कोविड होगा, कभी मम्मी होंगी, कभी वाइफ होंगी, कभी बच्चे होंगे, और बॉस होगा, कुछ नहीं होगा तो, right? So things will happen.
मेरे अंदर एक थॉट है मे बी फिर मैं वापस यही सोचता हूँ करना तो मुझे ही है, बट मुझे ऐसा नहीं लगता है कि मुझे भी जो कुछ अचीव करना है मैं अकेले वो अचीव नहीं कर पाऊंगा. मैं आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट द प्रोफेशनल वर्ल्ड. करेक्ट,
एब्सोल्युटली नहीं कर पाएंगे. करेक्ट
करेक्ट.
ऑप्शन स्टेज ऑफ इट कम्स इन. अब मैं आई मे नॉट बी वेरी गुड एट मेकिंग प्रेजेंटेशन और डूइंग एनालिटिक्स, बट आई माइट बी गुड एट स्ट्रेटजाइजिंग एंड हैविंग अ विजन. I might be good at coaching, but I might not be good at something else that is critical to my work. So, aap bataiye fir kya karte hain?
Delegation and identify.
People who are stronger in that subject than you, right? So, what do you do in when you're setting a goal, let's say for fitness? Why do you go to a fitness trainer? Right? Yeah, mindset. Yes. मुझे mindset को change करना है. मैं coach के पास जाऊँगा.
Exactly. Yeah.
So I will do a couple of things. I will look at people who do the job better than me. I will look at people who can groom me towards doing that job better, maybe. Get direction. Somebody who has experience in that field. These are a couple of typical things that you would do. But if I will put too much in my plate beyond what I can chew, I will always have indigestion. And that is the symptom that you're talking about. You have indigestion. Deepthi has indigestion. जब पता है एक दिन में 24 घंटे ही हैं, या थैंक्स दीप्ति,
थैंक यू. बट दैट वाज अ नाइस, दैट वाज अ नाइस लाइन अमिता, आई विल रिमेंबर दिस इनडाइजेशन, आई विल कोट दिस एग्जांपल, रियली नाइस वन.
आई एम टेलिंग यू इट्स गिविंग यू इनडाइजेशन, हेडेक, एसिडिटी, गैस, चिड़चिड़ापन.
इट्स नॉट ओनली इन टर्म्स ऑफ हेल्थ इनडाइजेशन.
जब आपको इंडाइजेशन हो या बोलोगे ना नहीं मेरे को एक और पूरी नहीं खानी है, अगर खाओगे एक्शन लोगे वो तो आपको यू देन यू हैव टू बी आंसरेबल फॉर द यू नो व्हाटएवर हैपेंस, रिस्पांसिबल फॉर व्हाट हैपेंस आल्सो, बिकॉज़ एक रिजल्ट तो आएगा उस एक्शन का.
अच्छा, इन द इंटरेस्ट ऑफ टाइम, आई नो वी हैव ओनली 5 मिनट्स लेफ्ट, जस्ट अ क्विक लाइन, मे बी यू कैन आंसर इट इन आवर लेटर सेशन. हम कभी कभी रियलाइज करते हैं कि हम जब अपने मेंटी से मिलते हैं, करेक्ट, वो जिस सिचुएशन से वो बात कर रहा है, सेम थिंग वी आर ऑल्सो गोइंग थ्रू इट, राइट? So either we try to learn something, but वो हमारे ऊपर भी देखता है हम how to take this up.
So you, what you're saying is that, so in fact I'll expand on that. It could also happen that somebody is going through a bad time and you get influenced by their bad time that they're having and you, you know, complete buy into the structure. The advantage you have as a coach is that you're looking not emotionally attached there. Okay, and you need to immediately identify and have that access and catch yourself, which you're saying right now, right? Ki main ho jata hun. Supposing main bhi usi situation se ja raha hun, and now somebody who's a coachee or a mentee who comes to me, I end up identifying with him because same situation. You need to get present and have access to that. And you need to get present ki मैं ये सेशन में हूं क्यों. आई एम नॉट इन दिस सेशन टू प्रमोट अमिता और हर इश्यूज. आई एम इन दिस सेशन टू सपोर्ट द गाइज एंड गर्ल्स हु कम ऑन दिस सेशन. इफ माय कॉन्टेक्स्ट इज क्लियर आई विल गेट बैक ऑन ट्रैक. मैं ऑफ ट्रैक हुआ, मैंने उस चीज को आइडेंटिफाई किया, मैंने एक्सेस किया, मैंने बिकॉज आई हैव प्रैक्टिस, आई कम इमीडिएटली कैच माई सेल्फ, आई गेट बैक टू द कॉन्टेक्स्ट. आई एम सिटिंग हियर फॉर दिस मेंटी एंड आई कैन नॉट क्लाउड माई जजमेंट और corrupt my coaching or mentoring because main similar situation mein hu. You learn something from it, amazing, good for you, but the context cannot be forgotten that you are not sitting there as a mentor ki dono chal yaar ab dono hi jeevan bekar hai, let's you know kind of unite, make a union on this or whatever, you know, on a lighter note. आप प्रेजेंट नहीं होते ना, जैसे आप बोलते हैं कि अरे मेरे साथ भी यही होता है, दैट्स ओके, But the minute you start engaging in that conversation, from him, you have moved to you. You're not with him anymore. You're no more a mentor.
Good coaching. Yeah,
so is this statement correct that connect, but connect with detachment, not as an attachment?
If it works for you, yes, absolutely.
I kind of agree with what he just discovered, that if we get too attached, we will actually bring in our biases as we opened in the starting. So I think that's a very interesting point. If we look at it in a detached fashion, probably we also go through similar problems and we might end up finding our own problem solution. But when you're explaining that, stay focused on your mentee and not on your own personal problems, no matter whether they are in sync or not. And as he said, that detachment probably helps here. Good coaching tip.
Yeah, because you know, attachment kya hai? Attachment is ki main apne past ke saath us cheez ko identify kar leta hun. मैं अपनी बिकॉज एज ऑफ राइट नाउ व्हेन वी आर सिटिंग हियर देयर इज नथिंग इट्स जस्ट दैट वी आर सिटिंग हियर एंड वी आर हैविंग अ कन्वर्सेशन देयर इज नो पास्ट राइट बट द मिनट आई गो बैक ऑन दैट ट्रिप एंड आई गेट अटैच्ड मैं पास्ट में घुस जा रहा हूँ व्हेन यू आर सेइंग डिटैच्ड आई एम सेइंग गेट प्रेजेंट एंड वी आर सेइंग द सेम थिंग
ओके थैंक यू
मेक सेंस
या एब्सोल्युटली
थैंक यू एंड अमेजिंग यू नो बिकॉज That's how the sharing helps. People who may not even have asked, hopefully would be getting something. And you know, it will have given you some clarity. Just to wrap it up very quickly, it's extremely important that you have, you know, your context clear. And that is something we'll be addressing in our next session. The context and the structure piece of, you know, setting your goals. Which is extremely important and we sometimes miss out on it. And the mindset is really critical. What are you saying and to yourself constantly? You need to see it's Aikido, right? Aikido is what it's a martial art in which you use the opponent's momentum against that person. Okay. So when a critical fast bowler, wo speed of that ball ko bas touch karta hai in the right direction and it goes, right? So it is about that. You already, your minds, your what thoughts you have, what beliefs you have are extremely powerful. How you use them and leverage them to your thing is practice. Thoda dam lagega. Aasan hai, par dam lagta hai. And once you build that and that tree is strong enough, you will be able to take the fruits.
बट वही तो एक जद्दोजहद में फंसे हैं मैडम दम तो लगा रहे हैं बट मिसिंग पॉइंट कहाँ है वो ब्लाइंड स्पॉट हम जानते हुए भी अचीव नहीं कर पा रहे दिस इज व्हाट वी आर स्ट्रगलिंग
हाँ बिकॉज सो यू नो इट इज वो ना स्टेटमेंट बहुत ही सिंपल है बट उसके पीछे ना बहुत कुछ है वो बहुत कुछ के एड्रेस करने के लिए हमें वक्त चाहिए वेयर इज दैट कमिंग फ्रॉम यू नो एंड इट्स नॉट जस्ट फॉर यू इट्स ट्रू फॉर ईच वन ऑफ अस
Yeah, so Amita, I am sorry to interrupt, but we are done with our timeline. And before we close, I request again to all of you, please fill your attendance sheet so that, you know, whatever Amita has shared with us, we'll be sending you out through email so that you can refer to these tools and such wonderful references whenever you want. So... Please share your email IDs and details in the attendance sheet.
Sure. So, मुझे मोबाइल से वो एडिट करने में प्रॉब्लम आ रही थी मैं थोड़ी देर बाद लैपटॉप से फिर अपडेट करके भेजता हूँ ठीक है
थैंक यू अजय
थैंक यू
एंड गाइस वी विल बी हैविंग आवर नेक्स्ट सेशन ऑन द 23rd ऑफ मे सेम टाइम एंड Performance will be the topic. We'll just take on, if you have some questions from today, please make a note of them. We'll address those or we will move on to context. Thank you guys. Amazing.
Thank you very much.
Can nice we have a quick selfie when we stop sharing the screen and can we all kind of share, open our camera. Amita, if you stop sharing the screen. Yeah, that's
oh,
already
don't know.
It's done. And
koi baat nahi you're yes, looking amazing everyone
thanks for this session once again Amita.
thank you so much for participating
thank you
guys.
I'll take care
thank you
Thank you.
Quick one. Thanks. Bye-bye.
Bye. Thanks, bye. Charu. Thanks, Smithy. Thanks, Dipti, guys.
Thank you.
Bye. Have a great Sunday. Bye.
Bye.